Hello students, in our previous e-lectures we discussed about the laws of exponent. Today we are going to solve the statement sums based on the laws of exponents. By what number we should multiply minus 1 by 5 raised to power minus 1 so that the product of that number and this number is equal to 1 by 5 raised to power minus 3. In maths, if something is not known to us, we will assume that number be x. Let the number be x. Now we are going to form an equation. So, ATQ, according to question, we are going to form an equation. By what number minus 1 by 5 raised to 1 be multiplied? So, I have taken that number be x. So, minus 1 by 5 raised to power minus 1 being multiplied by x. So, that the product should be equal to 1 by 5 raised to power minus 3. Now, if you want to change the negative power, x raised to power minus m is equal to 1 upon x raised to power m. This law we have already discussed. So, here minus 5 by 1 raised to power 1, 5 by 1 raised to power 3. 5 by 1 is 5, minus 5 into x, 5 raised to power 3, 5 into 5 into 5. Minus 5 into x is equal to 125. X is equal to 125 by minus 5. We will cut it and the result is minus 25. So our result is minus 25. Moving to the next question. By what number should minus 2 by 3 raised to power 3 be divided so that the quotient may be equal to 9 by 4 raised to power minus 2. Now, let the number be x as we have discussed in the previous question, because we need to find out the number and we have assumed that number be x. ATQ according to question. By the same way, 2 by 3 raised to power 3 divided by which number we have taken that number be x, so that the quotient is 9 by 4 raised to power minus 2. Here, again the fifth law, if we are having negative exponent, we will take the reciprocal and the power will get positive. 4 by 9 raised to power 2. Change this division sign into multiplication sign by taking the reciprocal into 1 by x. Here 4 by 9 into 4 by 9, 16 by 81. Minus 2 by 3 raised to power 3, minus 2 by 3 into minus 2 by 3 into minus 2 by 3, minus 8 by 27 into 1 by x, 8 by 20 into 1 by x is equal to 16 by 81. Now minus 8 by 27 being multiplied with 1 by x, and when I'm going to shift this number to the RHS, this will go for division. Minus 8 by 27. Now, change the division sign into multiplication. We have to take the reciprocal. Minus 27 by 8. 8 2s are 16. 27 3s are 81. So, 1 by x is minus 2 by 3. But we need the value of x. So, x is equal to minus 3 by 2. This is the one way we have discussed this question. Now I am telling you the second method. You have assumed that number be x. I am just putting the simple number here. By what number 20 be divided to so that the quotient become 4? By what number 20 has to be divided to get quotient 4? The answer is 5. What you did? You divided this 20 by this number 4. So instead of that number, now the rational numbers are given to you, but you have taken out the method. You have to divide minus 2 by 3 raised to power 3 by 9 by 4 raised to power minus 2. In this way you have taken out the x. Again, if the power is negative, we will take the reciprocal, 1 upon x raised to power m minus 2 by 3 raised to power 3 divided by 4 by 9 raised to power 2. Open it. Minus 8 by 27, 16 by 81 x. Now take the reciprocal, because we are changing this division sign into multiplication. It will become 81 by 16, 27 3s are 81, 8 2s are 16. The answer is x is minus 3 by 2. So in this way you can do the division as well as multiplication question if you find this method easier. Moving to the next question, find the value of x so that minus 6 by 11 raised to power x divided by minus 6 by 11 raised to power minus 2 raised to power minus 1 minus 6 by 11 raised to power 2 raised to power minus 3. Now we are having two rational numbers who is having two powers simultaneously. So according to law, first we are going to multiply x raised to power m raised to power n, that is equal to x raised to power m into n. So minus 6 by 11 raised to power x divided by minus 6 by 11 raised to power minus 2 into minus 1, 2, minus 6 by 11 raised to power 2 into minus 3, that is minus 6. Now we have to find the value of x and x is an exponent. So I have told you in my previous e-lectures that to find the value of x, if x is an exponent, we have to take care of two things. There should be one single term in LHS as well as in RHS and their basis should be same. Now we are having two terms here. So we are just see which law is applicable between these two terms. Minus 6 by 11, minus 6 by 11. The bases are same. Division sign is between. So we are going for the second law. X raised to power m divided by x raised to power n is equal to x raised to power m minus n. Minus 6 by 11 raised to power x minus 2. Minus 6 by 11 raised to power minus 6. Now both the conditions are satisfied. So same base, equate powers. X minus 2 is equal to minus 6. X is equal to minus 6 plus 2. And x is equal to minus 4. Moving to the next question, if p by q is equal to 2 by 3 raised to power 2 into 1 by 3 raised to power minus 4, we need to find the value of p by q raised to power minus 2. Instead of minus 2, we can have minus 3, minus 4, minus 1. Now, the value of p by q is 2 by 3 raised to power 2 into 1 by 3 raised to power minus 4. I have to find the value of p by q raised to power minus 2. If there is equality, the same thing. Minus 2, we have to give it here also because there is an equality sign between. So if we are taking p by q raised to power minus 2, the same power has to be given this whole term as here. Now we have to simplify it. 2 by 3 raised to power 2, 4 by 9. Power is negative 3 raised to power 4. I have taken the reciprocal of 1 by 3, that is 3 by 1. 4 by 9 into 3 raised to power 4 is 81. 9 9s are 81. 4 9s are 36 raised to power minus 2. 1 by 36 raised to power 2. Because the exponent is negative, so we are taking the reciprocal 1 by 36. And 1 by 36 into 1 by 36 is 1296. So, we have taken out the value of p by q raised to power minus 2 is 1 upon 1296. Home assignment for today. Do question number 2 to 8, worksheet 5, chapter 4.